And today, a landmark decision. The U.S. Supreme Court upheld the health care reform law, and that means all of its provisions remain intact. Children under 26 can remain on their parents' health care plan. Children with pre-existing conditions cannot be denied coverage, and there will be no limits on how much policies pay out. The ruling also means all Americans will have to have health insurance or pay a fine. The court's opinion is being viewed as a taxing issue and not a health matter. Now, you might wonder how that is possible. 9 News reporter Tom McKee is live with a legal explanation of the ruling. Tom?
Well, Carol, during congressional debate on this issue, some suggested if the government can force you to buy health insurance, they could also make you buy something like broccoli. Well, Congress can't do that if the penalty for noncompliance is going to jail. But they could offer a tax deduction if you'd like to buy more vegetables. Now, that's the logic the court used, according to the Chase College of Law, constitutional law professor John Bickers today. There's a mandate to buy health insurance, but it can't be enforced by sending someone to jail. So you'd have to pay a penalty to the IRS with your regular annual income tax if you're in noncompliance.
That's why the Chief Justice, in looking at it, said, well, they couldn't require this under the Commerce Clause, so they couldn't make it a federal crime not to have health care insurance in the way that it's a federal crime to purchase marijuana or cocaine. But they are perfectly authorized to say, we're going to endeavor to change your behavior by raising your taxes if you don't do what the government wishes.
Now, Bickers went on to say that it's not a groundbreaking opinion because the law remains intact, and there's plenty of prior precedent for the ruling that the justices handed down today. Coming up at 6, one White Oak businessman could lose half of his business because of what the court did today. I'll have that story. Tom McKee, 9 News Live in Coryville.
Thanks, Tom. So what's next? Starting in 2014, almost everyone will be required to be insured or pay a fine. Medicaid will be expanded to cover more low-income people. And insurers won't be able to charge women more than men.